Okay, all you dusty guys and dusty gals, attic stairs. We're going to put in attic stairs today. And this is a kind of a difficult project, so you can figure on working on it all day long. Maybe I would take a weekend to do it. But as far as the layout, that's what scares most people. The layout and the cutting of the ceiling, you know, wondering if they're going to cut into a major joist or a supporting wall or something. And it's not that difficult if you just take your time, and I'll show you what to look for before you even begin to cut into your ceiling. And also to be able to cut a square hole, parallelogram or a trapezoid or something like that, to where you get your attic stair in there straight. Alright, the first thing, we're going to get the box, and it's the rough size of the opening that you need to cut. So we'll do that first. And what we'll do is we'll take this box and we're going to cut it along the creased edges, because that is the exact size of the rough opening that you need to cut. So what we'll do is we'll go ahead and cut it, because we have to take our attic stair out anyway, and then we'll put it up on the ceiling. You can see the square of it, and it's supposed to be 25 and a quarter by 54, and that's the size of this box, 25 and a quarter by 54. All right, if you have a closet or something and you have no access to the area that you want to put the attic stair, I mean, most places have some kind of access, but just in case you don't, cut your hole in the closet. That way it doesn't matter how poorly it gets patched, because it's not going to be seen. But anyway, let's... Okay, up in the attic here, you can see some people call those jack legs. That's what I call them. They're roof jacks, whatever you want to call them. Those would be tied into your main walls, which means that wall is now a bearing wall. And it also goes true for the ceiling joist. You can see where one end ends and the other one starts, and they're sitting where the jack legs are, roof jacks, whatever. Well, that's your bearing wall. Well, where we're going to be putting the attic stairs is right about where that piece of sheetrock is. So what we'll do is we'll go in there and we'll cut out and get rid of all that insulation. Now, one thing you have to be aware of is that you may have to call an electrician, because if you can't move it one way or another a few feet to get past a wire, then you are definitely going to have an electrician, unless you have a little bit of knowledge on how to put wiring in a box and kind of move it around. But if you have no knowledge of electricity, call an electrician. Now, hopefully you've got enough play in your wire where you can move it one way or another. Well, anyway, you can see where it's going to go. And these ceiling joists here are 2x4s. Since this is a pretty old house, the same way with the roof joists, they're all 2x4s. But back then, 2x4s were as strong as our 2x6s are now, because of all the grain in them. In other words, the trees were able to grow a little longer. The trees that grow nowadays, they're cut down pretty quick. Alright, also we have an attic fan up here, which we're not going to bother it. And the only reason we're putting an attic stair in here is for two reasons. One for storage, and one we're putting an air conditioning up here.
air conditioning unit. All right, down we go, and here we go. All right, one more thing you're going to have. Up here is you're going to have what they call strong backs.
What is that?
Well, that keeps the ceiling level. So your joist. So when you put your sheetrock up, you don't have a bunch of rolled sheetrock. The strong backs keep the ceiling fairly straight.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Anyway.
It's used for older houses, I guess, huh?
Well, no, they're in all the houses.
Oh, are they?
Yeah. Yeah, especially in long, long rooms. Big rooms, you know, where they got the big areas, like a living room or big bedroom, something like that.
Yeah.
That keeps the ceiling straight. In case one joist is down, the next one's up, next one's down, next one's up. This keeps them all pretty straight.
Huh.
Anyway, if you got one of these that comes across here before you put your attic stair in, you just cut around it and then move your strong back over one way or the other.
Well, now, are you cutting rafters in two up there too?
Yeah.
And does that not have something to do with the integrity of the structure or not?
No, it does not.
It does not.
Does not.
Okay.
Well, what we do is this is the size of the hole that we need to cut in the ceiling.
Okay.
And so what we do, take this. This is our template. And as you can see, my knife cutting abilities is not all that great.
Probably work better with a sharper blade.
You would think. You would think. You want to cut right along that crease, because that's the actual size of the hole that you want.
There you go, just cut that one over there.
This on the ceiling where we want the attic stair.
Okay.
Okay. Now as you can head up there, or we're going to tack it up, that's where our attic stair is going to go. And the nice thing about it is that we can move it around to where it looks the best, which in that case, that's about as good as we're going to do it. And that, like I was showing you in the attic, that wall with that header is the one that's our jack leg. That means it's our bearing wall. So we want to stay away from that, or not get into that. So we're going to put it right there. All right. Now the fun part, I'm fixing to give Eric a hammer. You want to do this, you don't need to do that. I'll go and see it.
Okay.
Okay.
Not as good as Eddie.
Yeah. All right, we're going to send Eric up the ladder, and we're going to find one of the ceiling joists. Okay, let's see. Come over this way about a foot from that wall there, Eric.
Right here?
Yeah, right in there. Poke your hole. Just take that hammer. Knock a hole in that wall.
All right,
now come back towards me. He's coming back to me. All right, now, can you tell where the ceiling joist is? Hopefully it's gonna be back. May have to poke you a bigger hole so you can get your arm up in there.
Yeah.
Okay, take your hammer and just kind of get your bigger hole so we can find out where the edge of it is. That about it right there?
That's about it.
Okay.
Looks all right.
Good deal. All right. Now what we'll do,
this.
Now what we're going to do at where the joist is, and then we'll carry this so that we're straight with this wall, so that we can mark the ceiling.
Okay, I think you can see what I'm talking about is now. Now we'll staple that to the ceiling so we can get our marks.
All right, now what we'll do is we've got our line cut of where our ceiling joist is. And so now this is what put up. And what we want to do is we want to keep this edge straight with this wall over here. So take a measurement. Whatever this measurement is here, which is like 9 1/4, we'll come down here and put 9. Okay, we got 9 9 1/4 on the other end right here. Then we'll take our box. And you can see that these ceiling joists, hopefully you can see this, the ceiling joists are in here a little bit more crooked than against the ceiling. What we wanted, I mean the wall. So what we want, we really want it more parallel with the wall. Put our template up here. And like I said, we don't want to carry too much about the ceiling joist. We want it more parallel with the wall because it's going to look better. But what we use this for is we use this to where we'll go back as close to as we can to this stud here, that ceiling joist. So we have one good ceiling joist to hit. Now, we take our two marks, we got this mark and this mark, move this over, line it up, and we'll put some screws in here. Just to kind of hold it in place so we can get it marked. Holy. Alrighty, move it around. Let's see what we got. There we are. Okay. You can see we have our template. And this is at the point to where if you want to move it, you can move it now. Okay, you can see our ceiling joist is in there a little crooked. That's why I say we want it straight with the wall here instead of at this end here, because we can shim this, make that work. Because it's going to look a lot better if we have the trim that's going along that edge is straight with the crown molding. All right, now we just follow our pencil around this. And as anything, this is just a rough measurement. This won't be our finished cut. Okay, double check, make sure you got everything marked. Check it real well. Because you only want to do this one time. All right. Take the template down. Okay, now all you want to do now is just cut just the sheetrock area out.